basically doing a review of the LowePro Powder BP rucksack. Scottish winters. They're either completely beautiful or completely brutal. And this one is just completely brutal. So let's go somewhere warmer and have a little bit of a look in there.
Why is finding a bag so hard? Whether it's like a messenger bag or a rucksack or a man bag or a mountaineering pack, just so bloody hard. Been on a bit of a quest recently to find a new backcountry pack. My beloved Lowe rucksack, which I've had for about 20 years of mountaineering, scrambling, going away for city breaks, being a Dossie student, pack rafting, all sorts of things. It's finally totally given up the ghost after many years of really faithful and good service. Been through a lot of camera bags over the years as well when I worked as a professional photographer, mainly Lowepro bags and all the camera bags. And they're pretty good at keeping my camera gear sorted out, but basically completely hopeless in the mountains, just really uncomfortable and not really equipped to take any more equipment other than cameras, and just really, really uncomfortable and not great. So I've been on a bit of a quest recently to find a new pack for backcountry photo adventures. Tried the Lowepro Whistler. It's just not really my bag at all. Had a look at some of the Peak Design ones, which are really awesome, but a little bit more travel focused, not really great for the sort of adventures I want to go on. So I've ended up with a Lowepro Powder, which I really, really like. Noticed that there weren't any reviews of this on the internet. I'm not really a review kind of guy, but I thought I would add this piece in just to help other people on their quest to find the perfect bag. Okay, there we go. Don't feel like I'm going to put an eye out now. So my first impressions of this bag are really, really good. I've just been out in the Cairngorms for a few days. Didn't really get any photography or filming done because of cloud and snow and all that kind of Scottish winter fun that we saw earlier. But first impressions are really, really good. I've probably got about 15 kilograms of gear in here with all the snowshoeing stuff and camera gear and winter wild camping gear. Felt pretty heavy in terms of picking the pack up, but once it's on my back, it's really, really good. Something that's really, really good about this bag that's really important for any backcountry rucksack is its ability to get weight onto the hips and to be able to adjust the back system as you need it to work. So maybe if you're walking, then you might want it a little bit tighter, whereas when you're climbing, you want to be able to free up your shoulders and your arms to move. Lowepro, I think, have designed this for skiing and boarding. I'm not really doing any of that, mostly climbing and scrambling, wild camping, walking, mountaineering, stuff like that. And it seems really, really good for that. So overall in use, really, really good pack. Really enjoyed using it, and more to the point, I didn't actually really notice that often that I was using it. It just faded into the background, allowing me to get on with what I was doing. Few little minor niggles, things like the shoulder straps, top and bottom, tended to slip a little bit. I suspect that this is just because the fabric's new and a little bit shiny. I think as it fluffs up a little bit with use, then those straps should start to hold a little bit better. Sternum strap, slightly running out of adjustment on it. I'm probably a fairly average athletic-y sort of build. As with a lot of Lowepro kit, kind of get the impression that this has slightly been designed for slightly larger person perhaps, but on balance I'm 6'2" and I found this to be a really good fit on me in terms of length of the back and just in terms of overall adjustment. Other little annoyances are the side attachment straps, which are really designed for holding skis. When I came to put a snowshoe in, they're not really great. Just where they sit, then they're going to end up getting cut a little bit by the sides of the snowshoes. So overall, this feels like a really good outdoor pack. It doesn't feel like a camera bag at all. You can tell that Lowepro have had input from all sorts of people who actually go outdoors and do other things other than photography. Little features that I really, really liked on it. First one is the hydration bladder pocket. here, space for a 2 litre bladder. There is a little loop here that holds it in place. And then there are straps across here for routing the drinking tube. On the sides, there are straps that are primarily for skis. And on the front, there are another couple of straps which are for snowboards. I'm not really using those for their intended purpose at all, but I just find it really useful to have a bag where I can securely attach equipment to it. So the weekend I had my snowshoes on the side and then snow shovel and stuff down the front, but equally that could be a tripod or any other sort of gear that you need to lash to your bag. And that worked really, really well. One of the features that I really, really love, particularly living in Scotland where it's always raining or wet, slushy snow and I always end up with horrid wet equipment and wet tent and stuff, is the waterproof pocket on the front right here. So, soggy waterproofs in there, it's great space, tent fly sheet in there. It's just all separated from my kit in here. Really, really nice, useful feature. Other little features that I really appreciate are things like the draw cords. I've got these really easy to pull toggles on them that are designed for use with gloves and one-handed operation. And equally, on the back for getting into the camera compartment, also nice big pull tabs that are designed to be operated with gloves. Lastly, we have got some little pockets on the hip belt that are perfect for storing your Haribo or whatever else you want to nibble on, or lip balm or a compass or a GPS or whatever. Last feature that I'm really liking on this is the lid pocket. The lid pocket, there is a smaller pocket on the top that's kind of really just good for a wallet or a small map or something like that. And then we've got the main lid pocket in here where you can store all sorts of stuff. I've just got some camera gear and my head torch and a gorilla pod and stuff like that in there. Works really, really well. Really good feature as well is the lid pocket can be opened from both the front or the rear. Means that if you've got stuff lashed to the front, then you can get at it in a different way, or indeed just entirely remove it if you don't want to have the lid pocket on at all. It's just really nice, thoughtful feature that just allows a lot of different use cases. Outdoor credentials for this bag, really, really good. But what about its photography credentials? Does it stand up to photographic and filmmaking use? I've got to say yes, it's just really nicely thought out. The bag comes with a camera cube, which I actually took out for this adventure. I'll show you that in place in a minute. I took it out because I really needed more internal space in this bag, and with the camera cube in place, then there wasn't quite enough room for all my gear. So mainly for camera equipment, the bag is designed to be accessed from the back, just so you can lay the bag down and get at your camera gear without getting the back all mucky and muddy and leafy and just grotty from whatever, you know, is on the ground. So it opens up like that, just really straightforward, and I've put a little bit of packing in there to protect my back from any hard-edged camera gear. At the moment, I've just got my drone in here, so it's really easy to remove. Just pull it out and I'm ready to go. I'm using one of the DJI cases here. That works really, really well. I've got my drone in this one. I'm thinking of getting another one of these bags, or maybe one of the Peak Design camera cubes, one of the smaller ones. That way I can slot them both in there and I can have my drone and my digital SLR and any other equipment neatly compartmentalized, but not taking up as much room as the camera cube itself. Rest of the camera gear I was carrying this weekend. I just had my digital SLR wrapped up in the top so it was easy access, and then all the accessories and things that I was carrying, I had them in the lid pocket. Not really a perfect setup. I didn't really feel particularly organized when I was shooting outside. It was just a little bit of faff while I found everything that I needed, but it worked pretty well, and I really appreciated that I could get out most of the stuff that I wanted in this part of the bag. So really, really good design. And what about the camera cube that the bag is supplied with? So just nice and neat, fits in there, very, very similar to in the Whistler. Unlike in the Whistler, there's a couple of differences. The camera cube itself is much softer and much lighter, and it's also attached with elasticated toggles, unlike the Whistler, which has got rigid toggles, and trying to actually get the things attached to each other is an exercise in real frustration. A couple of zippers, which you can pull open, stuff that away there, and then lots of organisation space. You definitely get a pro body in there and a few lenses. It's not the largest amount of space, but that's the trade-off, that you're getting a lot more space in the top of the bag, and a nice narrow profile, so it doesn't get in the way if you're skiing or boarding or climbing. But definitely enough room in there for drone, camera body, lens or two, little bit of sound gear, and that would be just about it. Just gonna zip up like this. Unclip the four toggles. Then the cube just slides out, and then there's a handy handle there for carrying it around. Ah, some whiskey, excellent. There's some oddness with this bag as well, some features that really just don't work for me. The first one that I really just can't get my head around at all is this tripod holster. There it is, kind of a standard camera bag sort of thing for putting the feet of your tripod in, but yet the bag is covered in lots of other lovely attachment points that are designed to hold securely big clunky things like a set of skis. So a tripod, pretty easy to hold. Let's get rid of this. Another thing that's a little bit odd is the elasticated loops that are on a lot of the straps. Understand why they're there. They're designed so that you can put the strap through and stop it flapping around in the wind and whipping into your face, which in winter time when everything's frozen, including you, is pretty unpleasant. But really in positions like this, they don't really matter all that much in terms of securing the strap, and all that happens is that they tend to end up getting worked into the buckles like that, and then you can't adjust the buckle because the elastic's jammed into it. So sometimes useful, sometimes not. On the side straps here, not so useful. On the sternum strap, I was forever trying to adjust it into to fit my chest, and it wouldn't quite fit because of the elastic bit here, so let's get rid of some of those as well. Lastly, stored away in the base of the bag is an all-weather cover. Kind of really, really good in theory, but if you've got all sorts of big chunky stuff all over your pack, like your skis or your tripod, then that's not going to fit. Rather annoyingly, it is actually stitched in place, so you can't get rid of it. So it's just a few extra grams that you're having to carry around. So let's get rid of that because I'm never going to use it. Just cutting this off, I'm going to cut it closer to the rain cover. The idea being I'm going to leave a little bit of a tail here. So if at some point I do want to maybe reconnect the two, maybe using some kind of Fastex buckle, then I've already got a bit of tail attached to the bag, I'm already sewn on, and if I need a bit of tail of tape on the rain cover, that's then relatively easy to sew on. So just move that there. Lastly, I wanted to say a little bit about the fit of this rucksack. I'm 6'2" and about 80 kilos, and it fits me just right. As I said earlier, get really good weight down onto the hips due to the range of adjustments and the length. Not really sure for somebody with a shorter back, my wife who's about 5'10", the back looks like it might be a little bit too long for her, but really not too bad, certainly once it's got a bit of weight in it. Also, regarding the load bearing capability, you saw in my introduction, can get a whole lot of kit in here. A little bit of drone stuff, a little bit of camera stuff, and then enough gear and food to head away for two, maybe three days in winter time. So that was a winter weight sleeping bag went in there, or a Scottish winter weight sleeping bag went in there, and then some snowshoes and stuff on the side. And altogether, over a few days walking, just felt really, really comfortable. Overall summary then on the Lowepro Powder BP 500 AW. Really, really like it. I like it not only as a camera bag, but I really, really like it as a outdoor rucksack. I barely noticed it in the last few days of walking. Just felt really, really comfortable. All my outdoor kit, my safety kit was exactly where I needed it to be and easily accessible. And equally, when I wanted to do a little bit of filming, even though the weather was rubbish and I wasn't doing very much, when I wanted to do that, I could get at all my kit really easily. And I think by fitting another smaller bag in here that will keep my drone in one place and then keep the camera and some lenses in another place, it's gonna work out really, really nicely. So basically, Lowepro, really, really good job. Thanks very much, guys and gals. And thank you all for listening and to watching. I hope you've got something from this review. See you again. Lastly, in case you were wondering why I'm wearing a woolly hat in the house, it's not because I'm really, really cold after being outside in the Scottish winter for a few days, but it's because my wife's a really keen knitter and she wanted me to include one of her creations in the time lapse at the beginning of this film, and I totally forgot to do it. So here it is, nice woolly headed hat that is also very warm outside. See you soon, bye bye.